Hello, everyone, and thank you for joining me today. Yes, the headline show, Lashawn Daniels, Grammy-winning songwriter, dead at 41. Lashawn Daniels, who helped write countless hits for artists like Beyoncé, Whitney Houston, Jennifer Lopez, and Michael Jackson, died Tuesday, according to his publicist, JoJo Pata. Pata told CNN that Daniels died as a result of injuries sustained in a car accident. He was 41. His wife, April Daniels, also shared the news in a statement posted on social media on Wednesday. "It is with deep sorrow and profound sadness that we announce the passing of our beloved husband, father, family member and friend, Lashawn Daniels, who was the victim of a fatal car accident in South Carolina," her statement read. A Grammy award-winning producer and songwriter, Daniels was a man of extraordinary faith and a pillar in our family. Known as Big Shiz, the New Jersey native worked closely with acclaimed producer-songwriter Rodney Darkchild Jerkins and was the pen behind some of the biggest hits from the 1990s and early aughts, which means the early 2000s. Some of his credits includes Michael Jackson's "You Rock My World," "It's Not Right But It's Okay" by Whitney Houston, "Telephone" by Beyoncé featuring Lady Gaga, and the now iconic Monica and Brandy duet, "This Boy Is Mine." He won a Grammy in 2001 for the best R&B song as one of the writers on the hit single "Say My Name" by Destiny's Child. This past June, Daniels told the Recording Academy for an article celebrating the song's 20th anniversary that the tune was inspired by a relationship he had been in with a woman who worried about his faithfulness. "I would be places, I would be at work, and if my girlfriend called or hear anyone laughing or speaking or doing anything in the background, she'd be like, 'Who's that?' Then she'd be like, 'Well, say my name and then tell me that you love me.'" And so he wrote a song about it and it made a lot of money. Now, the song was actually the premise of what I would go through. And we had the conversation of how embarrassing is that, Daniels added. Beyoncé was in a relationship at that time and she could relate well to the situation. Now, the song had staying power. Rapper Drake used the hook in one of his own recordings, which Daniels talked to Parlay magazine about last year. "I think as a writer, one of my proudest moments are when I hear the newest artist that's popping, great and respected, sample a song that I worked on," Daniels said. "Then when they mention you on Instagram, it becomes, 'Wow, I didn't even know y'all dug into credits like that.'" Daniels found love with his wife, April, a hairstylist and clothing designer, and they had three sons together. The pair were regulars on the 2012 We reality series Tamar and Vince, featuring their closest friends, singer Tamar Braxton and her then-husband, record executive Vincent Herbert. And I remember that so well. I remember them being on that reality show with Tamar and Vince. And even though Tamar and Vince may be at it while at dinner or what have you, he always stayed in a cool and calm demeanor. He was always the voice of reason on that show. So let me continue with the article. In 2013, Daniels was nominated for a Grammy for his work on Braxton's single, "Love and War." He had a great love for his gospel music and last year released his debut album as a solo artist, The Big Shiz Project. News of Daniel's death was greeted Wednesday with an outpouring of grief from the music industry on Twitter. The entire music community is feeling the loss of one of the greatest to ever do it, legendary gospel artist Kirk Franklin tweeted. Lashawn Daniels. We just stood together a week ago. No words. And that was from Kirk Franklin. Yes, guys. He's worked with some greats, like the article says, Beyonce, Michael Jackson, Whitney Houston. What's the other ones I mentioned? This Girl Is Mine with Monica and Brandy, I'm sorry, went blank for a moment. Yes, so when I first saw this article, guys, like I've been kind of startled a lot lately with those famous and talented people who has passed away, and this, I mean, it wasn't because of an illness, it wasn't because of this and that, it was because of an automobile accident. And that was right after the Memorial Day weekend. He was in South Carolina, so, you know, who knows what the details, the article didn't give a lot of details as to what the circumstances was to that accident. But, you know, the results is going to stay the same, whatever happened in the accident, the results are still the same. We lost a talented young man, 41. Yes, I did say young man. 41 is still a young man, and he has so much to offer, guys, so much more. And his life was just taken away so abruptly and so needlessly, which if it's not by natural causes, even with natural causes, it was like, wow, that was, you know, that person just too young for this and too young for that. But death has no respect of person, guys. It falls on the greatest and the not so greatest. It's something that everyone will experience unless Jesus come back real soon. So anyway, guys, I wanted to bring that with you. My condolences. Oh, I saw April a few times on that show, and she was also always so loving, and they appeared to have such a great relationship with each other, you know, just the gentleness of both of them as a couple. I love to see that, a gentle couple just making it, you know, power couple, just doing things. And I do like that it was mentioned that he was a man of faith. So I am so pleased to announce that, to share that with you guys, that he was a man of faith. And my condolences, of course, goes to his boys, his children. And that's going to be hard for April, but she appears to be such a strong lady. I don't doubt that she will carry on, but it's gonna be hard, but she's gonna do it. She's a strong woman. My condolences to any of his family and to his friends and colleagues. So guys, there you go. We lost another great person. We lost another talented person, and it never gets easy. It never gets easier to come to you guys to tell you news like this. It never seems to just be, it's not a matter of fact in any of the people that I've reported on. So you guys, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell, and I pray that I can bring you some happy news. Sometimes I try to be silly just to lift the atmosphere of what's going on in the world. and to all the people that has been hit by the hurricane. My prayers, my blessings are with you, and I hope that help comes very speedily, and that you get the relief that you need. God bless all of you guys. Thank you for listening. Good night.